Are you thinking about taking a trip to Europe but need help deciding if going is a good idea? If that's you, then this video may help in getting you the information you need to help you decide if a Europe trip is right for you. If you're new to the channel, my name is Ben. I own and run my own travel agency, and on this channel, I provide weekly travel information and tips to help you plan for your next vacation. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. So I've been getting a lot of questions lately from clients and even from my own family members if traveling to Europe is a good idea. So I thought I'd make a video on it because if they're asking the question, chances are those of you watching this video have the same question as they do. And this can be a little bit of a tricky question to answer because everyone has different levels of comfort level with regards to COVID. And then there's the level of complexity involved in trying to figure out all the different restrictions between all the different European countries. And if you heard recently, the EU just removed the US from its safe list. So what does that even mean? So in this video, I'm going to help answer those questions by giving you 7 things to consider if you're planning a trip to Europe. So let's go ahead and dive into the first thing to consider, which is the country or countries you're planning on visiting may or may not be fully open. So just because a country is accepting tourists, it does not mean that it is open for business. You can expect a variety of COVID-19 rules to be in place that might interfere with your vacation. So be prepared for curfews, limited restaurant capacity, closures of large venues, event cancellations, and other restrictions. You can find the current situation in your destination by going to the U.S. Embassy website for the country you're visiting. So for example, if you're going to be visiting Italy, you just search for U.S. Embassy Italy, and there you can find the measures in place for Italy or for whichever country you're going to be visiting. Number 2, be prepared to mask up. Masks are still mandatory in much of Europe, even for vaccinated visitors. In some destinations, it's even required outdoors. So be sure to pack a lot of masks, and if you're not sure if you need to wear one or not, take your cue from what the locals are doing. Number 3, you'll need to stay up to date on all the entry and exit requirements. This is something that I'm doing almost on a daily basis as I have clients heading to Europe in the coming months. And with the new recommendation from the EU to restrict travelers from the US, you never know what each country is going to decide to do, whether or not they're going to follow through with that recommendation or not. As of the release of this video, so far Sweden, Bulgaria, and the Netherlands are the only ones to completely ban travelers from the US. And I should say, the Netherlands is not a complete ban. They are requiring you to quarantine for 10 days, regardless if you've been vaccinated or not. And also, Italy has just changed their entry requirements. They're now requiring you to get tested within 72 hours of arriving into their country, regardless of your vaccination status. So if you're not relying on a travel agent like myself to keep you up to date on all the entry and exit requirement changes going on, as well as the cancellation deadlines for your trip, this could be very time consuming for you and trying to keep up with all the changes going on. And don't forget, you also need a COVID test to return back to the US. 4, limit country hopping and layovers. Did you know some European countries require you to present a negative COVID test, even if you're just connecting through their airport? And did you know that if you're connecting through a higher risk country than the one you're visiting, it can affect your ability to enter certain European countries? Well, to avoid this situation, try to keep things simple and try to get a nonstop flight from the US to whichever country you're visiting whenever possible. And if you have to connect to another country to get to your destination, just make sure you read through all the restrictions of your connecting country very carefully to make sure you can continue on. This is not the year, even probably going into next year, to try to visit multiple countries in one trip. Pick one destination and spend all your time there to keep things simple. 5, have your proof of vaccination or negative test ready. The airport is not the only place where you have to show your vaccination card or a negative COVID test. In France, for example, you have to either show a health pass with proof of vaccination or a negative PCR test taken within the last 72 hours in order to visit any major cultural attraction with a capacity of more than 50 people, like the Louvre or the Eiffel Tower. In Denmark, you have to show either proof of vaccination or a negative test in order to get a Corona Pass, which is a digital passport that is required for all indoor dining and many other activities, much like what New York is requiring right now. And just so you know, there are testing tents throughout Europe around most of the major attractions where you can go get tested, get the results, and then go visit those major attractions that you went to the country to go and see. 6, expect long waits at customs and immigration in Europe. They were long before the pandemic, but now you add in the checking of COVID-19 test and proof of vaccination, and you have a recipe for even longer wait times. If you're planning on catching a connecting flight or meeting up with a tour group, just be prepared to wait longer than you normally would. And lastly, number 7, don't go without travel insurance. If travel insurance is not something you normally invest in when you travel, you should reconsider it. If for some reason a country decides not to let tourists in, or if you happen to test positive for COVID before or during your trip, travel insurance can help recover the losses incurred from any of these scenarios. And most people are not aware of this, but the medical insurance you have here in the US does not cover you when you leave the country. And even if the country does have free health care, it only applies to the citizens who live there and not to foreigners or tourists. So if you end up getting medical treatment while you're in Europe, you can expect to pay those costs out of pocket. And if you do decide to get travel insurance, make sure it covers COVID-related issues, as most standard policies exclude this. Well, that will do it for this video. If the information in this video was helpful to you, make sure to like the video and consider subscribing to get more travel-related videos just like this one. And should you want a travel professional like myself to help you plan for your next Europe vacation so you don't have to worry about navigating all the different restrictions throughout Europe, feel free to contact me at btennis@dreamvacations.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in a future video.